Good morning, friends. Today we are talking about corn, calluses and callosities. These all subgroups are a part of a broad condition of over-keratinization. Now, keratinization is a process in which straightened corneum is formed and recycled. So, these patients have a hyper-keratinization process which leads to increased deposits of keratinin in the skin. Now let's come to each and every pathology. First, we'll talk about corn. So corn is a circumscribed, small, demarcated hyperkeratotic lesion which has a central translucent core. And this core is actually the generator of the hyperkeratinization. So, this corn will be painful on pressure. So, if you press the corn from the top at the level of the central core, it will be a painful thing. Now, corn are usually of two types. First, which is more common, which is called as a hard corn. It is also called as Heloma durum. It is also called as a classic corn. Dry corn or a horny corn. These are usually seen on the toes or on the plantar aspect of the foot. It can also be seen on a dorsal IP joint, and it can also be seen on digits. So it is called as a digital corn. A soft corn is also called as a Heloma mole. It is more painful and it is more commonly seen in interdigital area. It is relatively softer. And it is due to absorption of moisture due to sweat and maceration. And these kind of corn are more susceptible for fungal infection and bacterial infection. So they can be secondary infected and they can be more painful. These are most commonly seen in the fourth digital web space, and these are also called as a kissing corns. Now, coming to the reasons why they happen. So, the most common reasons are a bad footwear. So, these are the extrinsic causes, and the most common causes are bad footwear. So, poor footwear, tight shoes, open shoes or irregular kind of shoes are the most common cause of extrinsic corns. Now, there can be intrinsic reasons of corns, which are bony prominences, foot deformities, toe deformities like claw toes, hammer toes. You can have corns in hallux rigidus. You can have corns in malunions, cavovarus deformities, or any other kind of foot deformities. If you do any kind of foot osteotomies, then you can cause corn. And if you do some kind of a load shifting surgery, then you can have a transfer lesions of corn because of shifting of weight from one part of the foot to another part of the foot. So these are all the reasons of due to which the corn may occur. Now callus or callosities are hyperkeratosis, but they are more broad based and they are more diffuse kind of a lesion. They are also situated in more or less the same places, but they are less painful and they are more diffuse kind of a hyperkeratinization that we see in our practice. Now, coming to the treatment. The best way to treat any kind of corn and callosities is prevention. So, the most important thing that I advise to all of my patients is a better or a good footwear. You should change the footwear that you are wearing, and you should use a changed, modified and a softer footwear, which is a more broad based. So the toe box should be more broad based. It should not be very tight or very loose, and it should be a well fitting kind of a shoes with an adequate cushion. Also, you can use some kind of a metatarsal pads which are made of silicon, or you can make silicon heel cups if you have a heel kind of a cones, or you can use a silicon heel pads or silicon arch supports also. So silicone insoles will give a cushioning effect and decrease the chances of corns. Also, you can use a dedicated silicone toes. So they are dedicated wrap around the toes. So these are silicone wraps around the toes. So these are also orthotic devices that you can use. You can use some pharmacological agents which are used to degradinize the skin. These are predominantly made up of salicylic acid, urea and ammonium lactate. The most commonly that I use in my practice is a salicylic acid, which is usually around 12%, 10 to 15% in composition, and you can apply it in form of ointment or lotions. There are ready-made corn caps which are also available and which can be stuck to the portion of the corn, and they also will keratolyze the hyperkeratotic fragment. So you can use corn cap also, and you can change it at regular interval of time. So besides using these pharmacological therapy, you can also do a gentle trimming. You can do it with a sandpaper or pumice stone or a sort of a sand board kind of a thing. So gentle trimming and rubbing is also helpful in callosities. Very, very rarely in cases of corn, you can excise the central core of the corn, and then you can do continuous trimming with the, as I told you, with a sandpaper, pumice stone, or with a emery board paper. So you can do a trimming after the removal of the central core. Also, a repeated warm water compresses, or dipping your foot in warm water for a period of about 15 to 20 minutes is also good. So what we recommend is you take some warm water, add some salt to it, do a little bit of work on your callosity and corns. You can do a little bit of trimming with the sandpaper, and then you can dip your foot in that salt water for a period of about 15 to 20 minutes, and that also will lead to softening of the corn or the callosities. But surgical correction or surgical removal of corn is a thing which we should do at the last stage. These are not the first stage procedures. Very, very rarely we also would like to do deformity corrections to actually cure the problem of corn. So if the corn is occurring due to foot deformities or toe deformities, then we can do a surgical correction of the toe and foot deformities to improve the corn and the callosity formation. So friends, hope by this video I have given you a broad overview of the conditions which can cause corns and how can we address them with homemade treatments. If you have any more doubts, please feel free to write us on the comment box. Thank you.